Hey, hi. I'm back with another Toru Dutt poem, The Lotus. So again, like last time, I'll give an introduction about the poem and I'll read out the poem and then I'll give an explanation. We'll also look into some other interpretation that has been done on this poem. Okay, now let's get into the introduction part of the poem. So The Lotus by Toru Dutt is a sonnet of 14 lines. So the rhyme scheme of this poem is A B B A A B B A C D C D E E. This rhyme scheme makes the this poem a variation of Petrarchian sonnet. So it was mostly used by English poets like Milton and Wordsworth and others, many others. So now let's get into the actual poem, The Lotus. Love came to Flora asking for a flower that would of flowers be undisputed queen. The lily and the rose long, long had been rivals for that high honor. Bards of power had sung their claims. The rose can never tower like the pale lily with her Juno mane. But is the lily lovelier? Thus between flower factions rang the strife in Sykes' bower. Give me a flower, delicious as the rose, and stately as the lily in her pride. But of what color? Rose red? Love first chose, then prayed. No, lily white. Or both provide. And Flora gave the lotus, rose red dyed and lily white, quaintless flower that blows. Though the poem is about lotus, we see the poem revolves mainly around roses and lily. So if you take love as a character, love comes to Flora and asks her to provide him an undisputed queen of flower, which is the best of the best. So Flora is confused now. She says that there's a long rivalry going on between rose and lily for that kind of a high honor. And brads of power is none other than poet who recites epics. He himself has said that rose can never match lily because lily looks like Juno mane. Juno mane is wife of Jupiter and goddess of heaven. But still the confusion is not cleared. Still the question still remains the same. But is the lily lovelier? There's no answer for that till now, and the flower faction is still going on. Even the Roman god of love cannot decide who is the best. The dispute is still on. Then love wants a conclusion, so he asks, so can you provide a flower which has both the qualities of rose and lily? Is it possible? Then Flora asks, in which color do you want? So first love says that it wants in red in color, and then it gets confused and it says, no, I want in white in color. And then he says that why not in both? Can you provide both in can you provide a flower which has both the qualities, both the colors? Then Flora comes to a conclusion and gives him the lotus, which has both the qualities of rose and lily. If you want to go into a different interpretation of the poem, we see that lily is a symbol of purity and rose is a symbol of passion. So lotus is a symbol of both. And here we see that lotus is given more importance. And lotus is the national flower of India. So Indian culture is reflected in lotus, which has all the qualities needed. So Toru Dutt here is making a statement that Indian culture tradition is the best, which accepts everything which has all the qualities And she is portraying Indian culture through this flower, the lotus. So this was the interpretation and analysis of the poem, The Lotus. If you have any questions or doubts regarding this, please let me know. And if you have any other poem that you want an analysis on, please let me know that as well. I'll try to help you. Thanks for watching. Bye.